Thank you so much for coming to the show.
Good morning, Karen.
All right. I mean, the timing of the interview, now that there are two Chinese ships conducting marine research in our exclusive economic zone, first of all, have you confirmed this?
Karen, we do not have the wherewithal to confirm this on our own, especially in the east Pacific Ocean, because we do not have any radar equipment there to monitor the area.
Okay.
So on the in the West Philippine Sea, if it is far, our radar also cannot see them. But other agencies like the agencies of the U.S. and other countries who have satellites, they can monitor this.
Okay.
What action
will you be taking after that report that clearly a U.S. satellite has seen those two ships?
Well, the action that I would like the our government to do is maybe to inform or ask the Chinese embassy what these ships are doing in our AEZ without our knowledge.
Mm-mm-mm. So they have not asked for permission?
No, as far as I'm concerned, I've talked to Secretary Spiron, and there were no information regarding their visit to our AEZ.
How would you describe China sending two marine research vessels? What kind of act is this, given that under UNCLOS, another state has to ask permission from a sovereign coastal state that they did not do?
I think nobody is prevented from doing the research as long as we know what they are doing there, what kind of research they are doing. If you remember, Karen, about last year or maybe 2 years ago, the French ship came here also to research, but they asked permission from us. So all we need to do, all we are asking the Chinese to ask, to inform us what they are doing, so that we'll know what really is the purpose in coming to our EEZ.
But do you already consider this an affront to the country's sovereignty? You've called China a bully at one point for their actions in Scarborough Shoal. And yet, despite the relationship of the Philippines and China, they continue to act in this manner without asking permission.
In a way, it is. Because now, Karen, we must also understand that China also claims ownership of the area because of their so-called historical claim.
Mm-mm.
So if they send their ships there, then they may be sending those ships considering that they also own the area. And that's why it's a disputed area as far as everybody is concerned. So all we need maybe
even
from
as you're concerned or even only as China's concerned?
Our concern, everybody's, the claimant's concern there,
yes.
Because there are five states claiming the area anyway. So what we need really is to allay the fears of the neighbors of China, is to inform the other countries what their ships are doing there. Not only the service ship, but also their warships passing through our territorial waters.
Mm-mm. Is this a national security risk?
I think it is, yes.
So what action should the country take, given that a few days ago, you yourself said there were four Chinese warships, and then now there are two Chinese research ships, within Philippine waters?
The Chinese warships, Karen, that passed through the Cebu Channel, they passed through on four instances.
Mm-mm.
From February to recently, July.
Mm-hmm.
And in those instances, there were two or more warships passing through.
Okay, but just to clarify first, so we have the two Chinese ship marine research vessels out of the issue. Does China need permission to send their marine ships to our EEZ?
If they are on a peaceful research, because you know, Karen, the water naman is flowing from one place to another, and maybe they were just trying to study the waters there or whatever the fish, because the fish are migratory. Then I think they can do that, but they should inform us what they are doing there.
So you're saying China should ask permission?
Not really ask permission because peaceful naman yan eh. Parang it's just like innocent passage, but this one is going through and making research. They'll just inform us what they are doing, what they will do there, and what kind of ship is this.
So the fact they didn't inform us or ask permission, how would you describe China's act?
You know, because they have been there also with some of the ships, like they have the Chinese Coast Guard, the Chinese militia, sometimes the Chinese, the what they call the People's Liberation Army Navy, and they also do not inform us. So what is the difference between these service ships and those ships that have been going there regularly?
Okay, but then you don't know what those marine research ships are for. I mean, those research vessels. So are you taking a softer stand against this? You're saying it's okay for them to be there? This is within our EEZ, sir.
Yeah, but the EEZ, as I told you a while ago, is also claimed by the Chinese. So they are sending those ships, the way I look at it, is they're sending the ships there because they think and believe that that is also belongs to them. So I think if you compare the service ships with the PLA Navy ships, I think this service ship is more benign than the PLA Navy ships.
So are you saying now it's not a security risk? You're saying it's not a cause for worry? What are you saying?
If their intention is only to study the sea or the fish or whatever, the marine life there, then it is not a security threat. But if they are doing other things like making reconnaissance or surveillance of our positions, then it's a threat.
Okay, but how do we know what they're doing?
That's a problem. We don't know it because we don't have the capability to know what... We don't know the ships actually. If it is camouflaged as a spy ship, masquerading as a marine research ship, that we do not know.
Are we helpless? It sounds almost that we're helpless listening to you right now.
Because we can always protest to the Chinese government that it's like telling them that we know what you're doing and please inform us what you are doing there.
Yeah. Okay. Now, when you called China a bully, you described China to be a bully. What was President Duterte's reaction to that?
I did not get any reaction. But when I said that the Chinese are a bully, I was referring to previous years, like when they took mischief from us, forcibly from us, and also Scarborough Shoal, that was 2012 or 2014. Mm-hmm. But recently, they have not been bullying us because they have not occupied any new feature in the West Philippine Sea.
So you don't describe China as a bully today?
Yeah, I don't describe them as
you
a bully because what they're doing there, they've been doing those activities since the president came in.
Okay, so I mean, a U.S. aircraft is in Manila now, the USS Ronald Reagan. And last August 4, U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper criticized China's, this is a direct quote, aggressive, destabilizing behavior of swarming and militarizing the South China Sea. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Do you agree with the U.S. statement that China is aggressive? It is a destabilizer in terms of its behavior. Do you agree with that statement?
I agree. Because they have militarized the area. They have reclaimed shoals or reefs and made them into artificial islands. And they put long runways there, structures, and landed military aircraft and put in defensive weapons there.
Yeah.
According to them, it's defensive. So that's militarizing.
So you do agree that China is aggressive?
Yes.
Until today?
Yes, until today.
Okay, yeah. So does it make them a bully until today?
No, you know, if you listen to the Chinese narrative there, they said that we are not here to attack anybody, but to protect their own interests here. They always say that what they are doing at the in the South China Sea, in the artificial islands, are all defensive. Are all defensive.
Okay, and do you believe it?
No, Karen, if you have to understand that in military term, a defensive capability can be turned into offensive capability in an instant.
Okay, all right. Now, President Duterte, I mean, many felt that the government has changed its tone when it comes to China, when you were quoted as China as being a bully, and then Secretary Esperon was quoted as we were outfoxed. And then you have President Duterte saying that he will bring up our victory in the arbitral tribunal to President Xi. Did he discuss this with you?
No, but I have heard him say that since the start, that in the proper time, during my term, sabi niya, I'm going to bring this up with the President Xi.
Is it the best time to bring it up now?
I don't know. I think only the president knows the timing.
Okay. Now, during the sauna, President Duterte also said he asked permission from President Xi to explore the West Philippine Sea. It was a direct quote. And the Chinese president said, we're going to have a problem there. Should we have asked permission? Should the president have asked permission from the Chinese president to explore our very own waters?
I don't think I can answer that. I don't think I can. I think this should be answered by the higher level.
Okay. Now, a few days ago, you said that at least four Chinese warships passed through the Cebu Strait in the waters of Tawi-Tawi, that they've been passing there since February. This is correct?
Yeah, four times since February. Mm-hmm. And all those times, there are more than two ships at any one time, yes.
All right. Now, the AFP described this act as an act of duplicity because the AFP said they traversed Philippine waters, number one, without prior notice, and number two, with their AIS, or it must be some automated information system, turned off. Do you agree with the AFP that that was an act of duplicity?
You know, when you use the word duplicity, there is an intention to deceive you or do something on the side without your knowledge.
Yeah.
But if these ships are only passing through, then I will not call it duplicity. I only call it as somebody who is passing through silently without informing somebody who owns the territorial waters.
Okay.
So now I have raised this with the Chinese ambassador during the opening of the Senate because he was there. And the first thing I asked him was, first I asked him if the Liaoning really passed through Cebu Strait, and he said no. What about the four times that your warships passed through Cebu Strait without that under AIS was turned off? And they failed to respond to our radio challenges. And you know what he said? He said, that is wrong. We should not do that because we are friends. Mm-mm. So he said, I'm going to inform our PLA Navy to inform the Chinese embassy so that he can inform us if they are passing through.
Okay. But the WESCOM also said, did the WESCOM report this to you, that the Chinese warships ignored their radio warnings, and even one vessel passed by the waters of Balabac, Palawan? That's quite close.
No, Balabac, Palawan is actually, it's already open sea.
Mm.
What is more concerning is the Cebu Strait because it is between our islands.
Mm-mm. Okay, Tawi-Tawi.
Yeah, in Tawi-Tawi. If they pass through Balabac Island and they are, I think, more than 20 nautical miles away, I think that's already international waters. So I'm more concerned about the Cebu Strait because that is our territorial waters, not the Balabac Strait.
Now, if proven that China ignored the radio warnings of the Philippine WESTCOM, no, itong Western Command, that's why the AFP said there was an act of duplicity. It means that they were contacting, tapos inignore. What actions will we take as a country?
We protest. We file a diplomatic protest through our Department of Foreign Affairs.
That's the only thing we can do. Okay.
Short of firing warning shots at them, but can we do that?
Yeah. is that the only option we have? I mean, you know, why can't we do a Vietnam? Just recently, Vietnam demanded China to stop its unlawful actions and demanding China to remove their oil exploration ship near the Spratlys. They have a standoff. So my question is, many have asked, can't we do a Vietnam?
But different. That's different, Karen. Mm-hmm. They are putting up oil rigs to drill for oil. And it is, if you do that to our, in the West Philippine Sea to drill for oil, then maybe we would be doing another action other than only challenging them.
Mm-mm-mm. Okay. Before I leave this, China at this point is expanding not just, okay, they've expanded not just in the West Philippine Sea, building artificial islands. They now have, is that correct? They've reclaimed seven.
In the West Philippine
Sea? Seven reefs. No, in the West Philippine Sea, two.
Two, yes.
But all in all, they've reclaimed seven.
Yeah, including in the Paracels, which is so far away from us.
Okay. Yeah. Now, Chinese investments in the Philippines have also expanded. I wanted to ask you, because you said you were concerned. And there are three strategic Philippine islands with Chinese financiers. And no less than the Philippine Navy has raised alarm. One is Fuga Island, Chiquita Island, and Grande Island. So Fuga is located...
Fuga is located off Cagayan province.
Oh.
Yes, and the Grande Island and Chiquita are in Subic.
Yes. Is this a cause for concern?
It is. First, I have asked the CESA under Secretary Lambino, Raul Lambino, to give me some of the documents concerning the development of the Fog Island by Chinese developers. And I will get it from him and study it, what kind of facilities are they putting up there. And if these are threat to our national security. I have also talked to the Navy, and the Navy suggested that maybe we should put up also a detachment there of Navy in just the tip of Poga Island to monitor what's happening there. Now, regarding the Grande Island in Subic Bay and Chiquita Island in Subic Bay, I will be meeting with the SBMA administrator next week, Ms. Attorney Amy Isma, because he said he has some information to me about the development of the islands.
Do you believe that they should ask permission first, or it should have the clearance of the Department of Defense before Chinese investments are put in strategic parcels of land or islands in the Philippines?
Not permission, Karen.
Clearance.
They should have discussed it with us, that what do we feel about what's happening there and what are our concerns.
Uh-oh.
So that before they sign a contract like they did in Fuga, mm-hmm. because all the contracts already, I believe, this was already signed. I think this was signed by Mr. Raul Lambino during the second Belt and Road Meet conference in Beijing sometime in February. And we didn't know that he was signing already contracts for these people, companies to go there.
And you believe that's wrong? That was wrong? Was it?
It is inappropriate, maybe. It's not wrong, maybe. We could also agree, for as long as we are informed that what's happening there, so that we will mm-hmm. know what's happening, because the Baboyan Channel is a very strategic crossing for our ships for of everybody.
That's what I wanted to ask you, because the Philippine Navy issued a statement and said the water surrounding Fuga Island is home to telecom cables and mm-hmm. historically was a jump-off point for troops during World War II. So if I were to ask you now, would you allow Chinese development in Fuga Island based on the Philippine Navy's reaction?
Depends on what kind of developments are these. If these are just resort, I think this is not a threat to our security. Resort, and then they will cater to tourists. I think we could allow that, but we should discuss first what kind of safeguard we can put there so that it will the they will be doing what they said they will be doing inside
okay.
the island. Yeah.
You don't see this as creeping annexation. Isn't this dangerous?
No, because we invited these people.
We being you or we
the
being...
The Philippines, because we attracted the investment here mm-hmm. in the first mm-hmm. place. That's
okay.
why we...
But you don't consider these islands as maritime fronts?
Of the Philippines?
Yeah. Because even the one in Subic Bay, that's at the mouth of Subic Bay, Chiquita and Grande.
Now, the Chiquita and Grande are a different story, Karen, because they are at the mouth of Subic Bay, and that is where we are going to park a lot of our assets, capital assets, later on.
Mm-mm.
And we do not want anybody...
Building.
Anybody monitoring us that we are not sure if they are with us or for somebody else.
Okay, very good. So this is something clear right now. So you will not allow Chinese building in Chiquita Island in Grande that's off Subic Bay?
Not, I don't say I will not allow, but we are going to monitor their activities, because the first information that I get is that this is a resort company that went there. In mm-hmm. fact, it is a Filipino company,
mm-mm.
Filipino company, Chinese company. And that's why I don't know what kind of arrangement this company made mm-mm. with any other outside company, because that is the information that maybe...
But don't you find it ironic? I mean, the U.S. bases were there at one point, somewhere near.
Yes.
And then you have... Chinese investors going to those two strategic islands.
Yeah, it is very ironic, really. Yeah, yeah.
But what will you check? I know you will meet with SBMA next week. What will you ensure?
We will ensure that those islands will not be used to spy on us, not be used for a staging point for any adverse action on our interest in Subic Bay.
Mm-mm. Thank you for watching. For more videos, subscribe to the official ANC YouTube channel and click the I button.